Hello guys and welcome back. So this is what we left off from last week. We've created the main block and we shaded it properly, and then I did a copy of this geometry multiple times and did a mirror of that. So we have, if we dive inside, this is the final shaded version with all the shading information in there, and then we did the copies like this. And then the mirror of that. So let's hit render. I have an environment light with just a white color. Actually, let's delete that. So let's create a new environment light just so we can have something. And then let's create a render view. Cool. And let's go to the render and create a mantra node and make sure the rendering is set to physically based rendering. I'm gonna leave everything as the default. I'm gonna hit render. And we should see the arches rendering very shortly. It's generating the scene now. And creating the geometry, displacing the geometry. I'm going to talk about that, why it's happening in a later video. Cool, so it created the geo and it is rendering. If we take a look, we have all the shading information that we've created. And what I've done also is I assigned, I didn't assign the same pillar shader to everything. I gave these guys just a white diffuse, and only this block has a texture and the edge wear and everything. That's the only difference. Last time we assigned everything to all the objects, and to save render time I just assigned a white diffuse in there. Cool, so it's working. Great, let's turn this off. It was taking 6.1 gigabytes memory. I'm gonna snapshot this, and we need to use packed primitives because it's currently we're wasting a lot of time and memory by duplicating this as a geometry. So we need a way of reusing that packed information so Mantra knows how to deal with this efficiently. So let's go back to the main pillar. And in the copy here, I'm going to turn on pack and instance. And if we middle click, this is going to turn it into pack geo. And we have 10 copies, and then they get mirrored. So 20 geo, 20 pack primitives, one per block. Okay, and let's hit render again. So you see the scene generation took a lot less, and it is much, much faster. And the memory is also a lot lower from 6. Gigabyte went down to 4 gigabytes. Cool, but we've lost all the shading information. We don't have any of our shaders anymore. And the reason for that is because the way Mantra exports the shader, the way it knows what is assigned to the object, is by looking at the properties of the primitives. And right now, if we click, it's only packed geo. There is no shader information here. There is no shader information here. And then if we click at the original mesh, we see that we have this shop underscore material path, and that is getting created by this node. So whenever we set the material, it creates this attribute called shop underscore material path, and it sets it to this guy, and it's a primitive attribute, and that's how Mantra knows the shader to assign to the geometry and what to export when we hit render as well. Because if it doesn't find any use for the shaders that you have in the scene, it's not going to export any of them. And what's happening right now is the geo is being exported as a packed primitive. So Mantra doesn't see any shading information about it. So it exports only the geo, but when it unpacks it for rendering, it realizes that there is no shaders available in the scene because it didn't export them. It ignored them. Mantra ignored them at this level. So what we're going to do is we want to force Mantra to export all the shaders, so when it unpacks these guys and starts rendering them, it can find the information, and we don't want to rely on the exporter to decide what shader to include and whatnot. So in the Mantra render node, there is an option under the render tab called force vex shader embedding. So I'm going to turn that on, and what it does is it forces exporting all the shaders, whether we need them or not. And let's go back. So it's exporting, let me go, sorry, it's exporting one block. I had the wrong node. So ignore this image. Let's hit render. Now it's exporting, we have 10, we have 20 packed primitives, and we forced the shader export to happen. But if we see it's still not working. And the reason for that is because what's happening is this guy, when it packs the geometry, it does not export the shading information. When we do the packing here, there is data, there is different in results. So now it's only 10 packed geo, and that is one per each block. And this block contains a lot of pieces. If you guys remember, we have this element and this element. They're all individual. But now we're dealing with that as one object. So we're overriding all that information. And what we need to do is we need to turn off this pack and instance thing. And we need to create our own, we need to pack this data ourselves. So I'm gonna create an assemble node. And I'm going to turn on create packed primitives. And if we middle click now, we should see that it made the correct packed primitives needed for this entire object. And each piece now has the information. It can be extracted back again. So let's go back here. Now we have 2300, 2400 packed primitives. And then that's going to get copied. But this is still going to be efficient. So let's hit render and see what we get. Cool. So it exported all the data. You see the memory went up. So there is more data stored, but we still don't see the shader. We still don't have the shader assignment. And the reason for that is when we did the assemble here, there's no information passed to those points that keeps the shading information. When we pack the data, everything is lost. And Mentra only knows up to this point. So what we need is we need to transfer the shading information to the point level. And the way we do that is using this transfer attribute here. I'm going to turn on a click here. I'm going to select the shop underscore material path. And that is going to transfer this attribute to the points. It gets copied, so each one knows what it gets. And then if we hit render, now, we should see the shader attached to all the objects. Cool. So everything is working. You see that the memory went up, even though we're using this very efficient workflow. The memory went up compared to the raw geometry data. And I'm not so sure what's happening with the packed primitives, but this is not doing proper instancing. And I'm going to show you guys the correct workflow. I just wanted to explain this workflow using the packed primitives and how to transfer the shader if you needed to, because this is how crowd and other things work. So now that you know about the shading, we're going to talk about the proper approach to doing instancing. And we'll continue talking about this in the next video. Thank you guys for watching, and see you in a bit.